All right, so the game is final. Now, this is a bit awkward. I wasn't expecting to come in here and talk about a tie, but let's talk about what happened. First and foremost, let's talk about these officials out here for both Cleveland and Pittsburgh. This was a terribly officiated game. Number one, on the first Pittsburgh touchdown, whatever call they called on Myles Garrett saying roughing the passer, that was straight up bullshit. If you're a Cleveland Browns fan, you should be pissed off too, because that should have forced the field goal. It should have been 3-0 from there. But talking about the Pittsburgh Steelers, first off, we were not disciplined all day. At all. Big Ben, it starts with you. There's a reason why I'm wearing this jersey. The jersey, because you are the ringleader of the offense. The first interception, hell of a play from Denzel Ward. That is entirely on the defense making a play. The second one, that's miscommunication between Big Ben and AB. I saw the seam. I saw the route. He was going to be wide open. You hanged it up for him. I don't know if you spoke to him in the huddle before. I don't know if he changed it on an audible, audible while he was running the route. Whatever the case was, you guys got to get that down. The third interception, Jesse James, you got to be able to catch the ball, baby. You can't have these times where the ball's in your hand, you dropping it. I understand the down and distance, the weather conditions, but you got to be able to catch the ball, period. And then the fourth interception, which really should have been a fumble. I mean, hey, that's just a hell of a play from the defense. But offensively, James Conner showed up. He got over 130 plus yards on the ground. I think he had about, 25, 26 carries through the air. Juju Smith-Schuster, well over 100 yards. AB, 9 catches, 93 yards, and a touchdown. We got it done through the air. It was the minute things that kept the Browns in the game. This isn't a game in which the Browns dominated the Pittsburgh Steelers and kept themselves in the game. This is a bunch of mental errors. You can't win football games if you turn the ball over 6 times. All right? For the Cleveland Browns, surprised me, not really, because I knew they were going to come out here and play well. It's one thing to cut a promo in a pregame, but I've been saying it for the longest. This Cleveland Browns team, I believe they can win about 6 games this year. Maybe even 7. The playoffs, I don't know about all that, but they'll be able to be way better than they were last year. This isn't the same the Cleveland Browns of the past decade and a half. Oh no, this is a whole new Browns team. They come in with a new intensity. Hugh Jackson had them queued up this game. On top of that, this is a rivalry game, so people got to come out here and play well. Defensively, I loved what I saw from Pittsburgh. I loved it. They didn't have a 100-yard rusher, Carlos Hyde. At one point, he didn't have about 50 yards. He had one run where he broke it for about 15, but he would have been under 50. They played phenomenal. When it comes to the pass rush, phenomenal. T.J. Watt, I think he had the blocked field goal in overtime. I'll be getting to the field goals a little bit later myself. And also, 3 sacks on the day. In coverage, played great. Josh Gordon only had about, 2 catches? Maybe 3? It might have just been 1 for the touchdown. I liked what I saw from Cameron Sutton. I loved what I saw from Edmonds. I loved what I saw from Sean Davis. Joe Hayden did his thing. There were times where guys were rotating and coming off the field. Might I add in the fourth quarter? There's no reason. Coaches, Fickner, whether it's going to be, whether it's Keith Butler, Mike Tomlin, whoever's making the substitutions, our defensive line coach, when you're substituting late in the game, it's under a minute. There's no reason to be substituting. We got a 12-man on the field penalty when that should have never happened. All right? You got to play smart. Mental errors. Our coaching also cost us this game as well. Not only the sloppy play of the offense being able to hold on to the ball, our coaching as well. We didn't get out coached, but we coached ourselves into a ditch. You can't let that stuff happen. Now, moving on to overtime. Played phenomenal in overtime for what I saw. You got ourselves down in field goal position, and then what happened? You got a high snap coming from our long snapper. Barry was able to get the ball down, but it went wide to the left. It looked like Boswell went to Nick Folk University. It's unfortunate. I understand the conditions, but you got to be able to make these kicks. This is what you're getting paid for. You got to make the kicks, Boswell. You got to make the kicks. Down the line, they went to go kick the opposing field goal for the Browns. Luckily, it got blocked. Last play of the game, I guess it was going to be a pass over the middle, possibly lateral it, run the hook and ladder to possibly win the game. I don't like the play call, but understanding the down and distance, also the weather defects as well, there's only so much you can do. Big Ben's able to haul about 60 yards into the air, but if it's raining, that might just slip out your hands. I'll say this about the Cleveland Browns. Phenomenal game played by the Cleveland Browns. Myles Garrett, this man's going to be a stud. You already see the way he looks in his physique. It look a whole lot like a Curse from back in the day. Jermaine Curse, Javon Curse, I think it was one of them too. All right, no, not Jermaine Curse. I think that's a receiver. Javon Curse, the one who used to play for Tennessee, also went on to go play for the Philadelphia Eagles. That dude's body, similar to Myles Garrett. Jabril Peppers, they both played well. Denzel Ward had himself 2 interceptions. I like the way the Cleveland Browns look, but for us, the Pittsburgh Steelers, we got to play better. Cannot go out there and turn over the football like that. 6 times, inexcusable. But A tie is better than a loss. You saw what Baltimore did out here. They just went and butt-raped the Bills. The Bengals, I believe they beat the Colts. So the way I see us right now, we're number 3 in the division. Matter of fact, might as well just put us number 4 because we didn't come away with the W. All right, we are back-to-back AFC North defending champs. Next week, playing against Kansas City. I don't know if Le'Veon Bell's pulling up or not. A lot of people talking about, well, we don't need Bell. Trade him away because James Conner played well. It's one game. All right? But you got to play disciplined. I'm not a fan of how we came out here and played. You cannot play undisciplined football like this. You can't win championships like this, let alone games. All right? I look forward to seeing a better performance out of the Pittsburgh Steelers moving forward. However, I will say this. Our offensive line played absolutely phenomenal, except down the stretch when we were turning over the football. Guys got to be able to hold on to the football. I recognize the weather, but you're playing football out here. Whether it snows, it's a damn hailstorm outside, thunderstorm, you're obviously not going to be on the field. But if a tsunami came on the field with a monsoon that they had down in Carolina a couple years ago, you got to be able to hold on to the football. Take off all that fancy compression stuff. Take off those gloves. Take off that tape and play old school smash mouth football. You got to be able to hold on to the ball, baby. But still, walking away with a tie, much better than a loss. A lot of people going to go around talking about, you tied the Cleveland Browns. You suck. I guess it could be warranted. It's a whole new season. They're basing everything off on the past. Doesn't matter. You got to look towards the future. We got Kansas City coming up next week. Got to play well because Kansas City already came out the gate explosive playing already. So you got to get our minds right. All right. Disciplined football. That's the lesson for today. Disciplined football. But I don't turn my back on my team. Neither do you. Everybody get your hand back up in here. All right. Steelers on 3. Win on 6. So I should say resilience on 6 instead of just win because we went out there and tied the damn game. So we're going resilience on 6, all right? 1, 2, 3, Steelers. 4, 5, 6, resilience, man. Get our head out of our asses. Come on.